Yes, good morning, students. Let's have the discussion of the reported speech, which we also call as direct, indirect speech, and the narrations also. We have already discussed, but just for your revision, I'm going to repeat all the rules. First thing is, what is a direct speech and what is indirect speech? Direct speech is a report of the exact words used by a speaker or writer. The words spoken appear within inverted commas and should be exactly word to word as spoken or written. Means jaise kisi speaker ne jo words bole hain, as it is unko hum inverted commas mein, as it is same speech ko reproduce karte hain within the inverted commas, that is known as direct speech. You can see the example given. The teacher said to the students, comma, inverted commas begin, you can go, inverted commas closed. That means the speech which is given to you in the inverted commas is known as direct speech. So in this way, when we are given the exact words of the speaker within the inverted commas, that is known as direct speech. Next, when we report what someone said in our own words, it is called indirect speech. We do not use inverted commas, do not write the exact words as spoken or written by someone. Note down the difference, direct and indirect speech. When we report the words of the speaker in our own words, apni language mein hum usko convert karke report karte hain, and we don't use the exact words and we don't use even the inverted commas. See the example, the teacher said to the students that they could go. We have removed the inverted commas. So it is indirect speech. Some changes are made in the speech while reporting it to someone else. Now see again the next slide. Both direct and indirect speech have two parts. That when we have the reported speech or the direct indirect form, in both these forms we have two parts of the sentence which are complete sentences in themselves. Ki agar aap unko separate padho to wo apne aap mein complete hote hain. See, one is reporting verb and the second is reported speech. It is reported verb and reporting speech, opposite is written. Who said to whom, it is reported verb, and the reporting speech is the exact words spoken put within the inverted commas. कि जो inverted commas से पहले आता है उसको हम reported verb कहते हैं, और जो inverted commas के बीच में है, that is known as reported reporting speech. See the examples, inverted commas. What is the difference between these two, direct and indirect speech? How we can identify and differentiate? Inverted commas will be removed. If the indirect speech is there, we add conjunction that if the sentence is in simple sentence positive form, change in the verbs in the reported speech, changes in personal pronouns, then change in the nearness of time and place adverbs. These are the changes which we do while changing the direct form into indirect form. First, inverted commas removed. Second, conjunction that is used. If the sentence is simple, change in the verbs according to the table which is already given to you, then change in the pronouns, then changes in the words used for nearness of time or place. You may call it as adverbs. Then how we change the pronouns, you must remember the rule for this, son, that is already discussed with you. Son means if we have subject in the reporting verb, we will change the first person of the reported speech with subject of the reporting verb. S ke niche dekhiye one aa raha hai, that one refers to the subject, first person subject. Means aapne kya dekhna hai ki reported speech mein agar aapke paas subject first person hai, first person means I, we, me, us, my, our, I और we से जो भी आगे ऑब्जेक्ट या प्रोनाउंस बनते हैं, एनी वर्ड आउट ऑफ दीज इज देयर इन द रिपोर्टेड स्पीच, दैट मींस फर्स्ट पर्सन सब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट pronoun, any word that is used in the reported speech will change with the subject of the reporting verb. And if there is a second person in the reported speech, that is you, it will change with the object of the reporting verb. Here you can be subject, you can be object also. For the possessive pronoun, your can be also used. And these three words will be changed with the object of the reporting verb. And if there is third person in the reported speech, then there will be no change. It will remain same. So the first person in the reported speech changes according to the subject in the reported speech. Then second person changes with the object in the reporting verb. And third person, no change. Next, see the examples. Ram said to me, I am going. Ram is the subject here in the reporting verb. And I am going. I is the subject here in the reporting speech. So I first person will change with the subject Ram. So uski jagah kya ho gaya? He. Ram told me that he was going. And we change said into told if the object is given. Kyunki hum kisi ko baat bata rahe hain. Ram said to me. Object diya hua hai. So humne said ko told kar diya. Agar object na ho, then don't change this said. It will remain same. Conjunction that is used, removing the inverted commas. Tense is changed. I am ki jaga kya ho gaya? He was. Person change ho gaya. I say he. Am say was. Inverted commas are removed. Look at the second sentence. You said to Radha, I am studying. Now see, in the reported verb, we are given object in the second person. You is given. In the reported speech, I first person is there. Again, subject changes with the first person. Subject changes with the subject of the reported verb. So I ko aap you ke saath change kar rahe ho, so it will be you now. You told Radha that you were studying. They said to me, we are playing. They said to me, reporting verb. And we, again, first person subject is there in the plural form. So, ab aap kya karoge isko? They mein change kar diya. Then, I said to him, Ram is a fool. In this sentence, we have Ram, third person is used in the reporting speech. So, there will be no change. It will remain same. Look at the next part. Change in the verb of the reported speech. How we change the verbs? First rule is, if the reporting verb is in the past, the verbs of the reporting speech will be changed into past. If you have a reporting verb which is given in the past, like said in the sentences, then you have to change the reported speech tenses ko bhi change karna hai. According to the rules or the table. If it is present, then you will past. If it is past, then you will past perfect. Karoge. You have that table with you. Now, look at the example. He said the doctor is in. Indirect form mein hum kya karenge? He said, we have not changed said into told because no object is given. That conjunction is used. Inverted commas are removed. The doctor is third person, so no change. Is changes into was. Inverted commas are removed. Exceptions of this rule are, sometimes we don't change the reported speech into past. When? First, if the reported speech shows universal truth. If the reported speech shows some habitual fact, if the reporting verb is in present or future tense. That means, agar reporting verb hamara present ya future mein hai, to hum reported speech ka tense change nahi karte. Aur koi universal fact hai, koi quotation hai, koi habitual fact hai, koi scientific fact aa jata hai. Even then, there is no change in the tense of the reported speech. Even if we have reporting verb in the past, we don't change the tense. For example, the nurse said to the patient, inverted commas begin, health is wealth. And how will change in the indirect? The nurse said ko change kiya, told the patient, inverted commas removed, that conjunction is used, health is wealth. No change in the tense. And note down one more thing. When we convert the direct form into indirect form, we don't use capital letter in the first word. Jaise health ka H capital tha. Ab humne indirect form mein health ka H small kar diya. Because it is in the continuation in the same sentence. Earlier, it was taken as a separate part within the inverted commas. So don't use capital letter when we write the indirect form. Clear? Look at the next examples. He says to me, you are wise. He says to me that I am wise. He says to me, aapko aap kis mein change karte ho? He tells me. There is mistake in this. Make correction. Note down that he tells me that I am wise. Says ko change kiya humne, tells me to ko remove kar diya. Conjunction that is used. You, second person, changes with the object. Object is me, so it will change into I. No change of tense. Is, am, are. Same tense is used. Inverted commas are removed. Next sentence, Ram will say to me, I am true. Future form mein aa gaya. Ab humara reporting verb is in the future form. So again, the rule is no change of tense in the reported speech. Ram will say to me, or isko aap change kar sakte ho, Ram will tell me that he is true. Again, no change in the tenses there. Clear? Next, note down the rules for the change of the tenses. Quickly, I'm going to read, otherwise I have already sent you this. Simple present tense, that means first form or first form with S or ES changes into simple past, that means second form. Present continuous, that means is, am, are, first form, ing, changes into past continuous, that means was, were, first form, ing. Present perfect, has, have, plus third form, changes into past perfect, that means had plus third form. Present perfect continuous, that means has, have, been, first form, ing, changes into past perfect continuous, that is had, been, first form, ing. Simple past, that means second form, changes into past perfect, that means had plus third form. Past continuous, was, were, first form, ing, changes into past perfect continuous, that means had, been, plus first form, ing. If the reporting speech is in past perfect already, then it will not change. No change will be there. Past perfect continuous, no change. That means had plus third form hai, ya had been plus first form ing aa raha hai. In the reported speech, then there will be no change. If the sentence has future tense, that means will or shall plus first form, we change it into would plus first form. Note down, shall is not changed into should. Dhyan rakhna hai ki agar shall hai, to bhi usko would mein change karna hai. Agar will hai, to bhi would mein change hoga. And with the would also, you will use the first form of the verb. No change in the form of the main verb. Then some model verbs are given, that if we have the reporting speech in the model verbs, can changes into could, may changes into might, must changes into had to, aap must ko must bhi rehne doge, that will also be correct. And all these modal verbs are followed with the first form of the verb. No change in the direct or even in the direct indirect speech. Koi bhi modal verb aa jayega, aap unko, uske agar uski forms, three forms of verb banti hain, to usko change karoge, lekin uske saath main verb jo hai, wo change nahi hoga. That will remain same in the first form only. Then the next slide, you can see the words of nearness of time and place that change if we change the direct form into indirect form. Here changes into there, now changes into then, this changes into that, these into those, today into that day, tonight that night, last night or week changes into the previous night or week, yesterday the previous day, tomorrow, the next day, next week, the following week, ago changes into before. You can see these tables in your grammar books. Any grammar book, if you take and you read the chapter of the reported speech, all these tables will be there. Now look at some examples. I'm going quickly have a reading of these sentences only. He had said to me, we play. Now the reporting verb is in past perfect and reported speech is in present. First form is given. He had told me that they played. Second form. First form changes into second form. Second sentence, he had said to me, we are playing. He had told me that they were playing. Present continuous changes into past continuous. He said to me, we have played. He told me that they had played. Present perfect changes into past perfect. Last sentence, he said to me, we have been playing. He told me that they had been playing. Present perfect continuous changes into past perfect continuous. Now come to the next form, that is interrogative form. That means the question forms, sentences, where mostly the students commit mistake. So be careful while doing the changes in the question form. First rule is, if the sentence starts with the WH words, that means who, which, when, where, whom, what, why, how, etc. in reported speech, then how we make the changes. And on the other side, you are getting the table. If the sentence starts with the helping verb question form, that means is, am, are, was, were, can, could, will, shall, do, does, did, may, that means all the helping words which we use in the tenses and the models. Where we get yes, no answers. How we change that? So you must keep it in mind for the question form that if we have question form, it can be of two types. One is WH question form and the second may be the helping verb question form and how we are going to change these sentences. First, look at the WH question form. If the sentence is given to you in the WH question form, first thing which you have to keep it in mind for both is that question form changes into simple form. Ye rule dono mein hai, chahe question form WH ho, chahe helping verb question form ho, to dono mein first rule humne kya follow karna hai ki question form will change into simple form. Wo kaise hoti hai? Because when we make the question form, we bring the helping verb in the beginning. If it is a WH question form, first we use WH word, then we use helping verb, then subject. The only change in the pattern is ki uske aage WH word add kar diya gaya. Otherwise, the same pattern which we follow in helping verb question form is used in the WH question form also. Ek sirf aap WH question word jo hai, wo extra add karte ho. So jab aap usko change karoge indirect form mein, or we are to use it, we are to change it into simple form. The simple form kaise ho jati hai? We'll bring the subject first and helping verb after the subject. Note down this change where you mostly commit mistake. Bahut se students is yahi mistake karte hain, baki sari changes aapki theek hoti hain. You don't change the sentence into positive form. Ki aap positive form mein kaise hoga? When we use subject first, then helping verb. Theek hai? Agar WH question form hai, to first WH word, then subject, then helping verb. So, आपने subject और helping verb की placement को mind में रखना है whenever you are going to change the question form. Clear? And then if we are changing it into simple form, that means no question mark is to be used at the end. Now it is a simple sentence. Then the second change is when we change the question form, we use conjunction if or whether. If the sentence is given to us in the helping verb question form, mind it, only in the helping verb question form, we use conjunction if or whether. And if it is a WH question form, no conjunction will be used because the WH word itself works as conjunction. Clear? Look at the sentences now. For example, the doctor said to the nurse, which injection will you give to the patient? WH question form, which injection will helping verb, you subject. Helping verb pehle hai, subject baad mein hai. Humne isko change karna hai, to humne helping verb piche le jana hai, subject pehle lekar aana hai. The doctor asked the nurse, question form hai, to said ko change karenge, asked mein. Simple mein hum told kar rahe the, ab asked. Kyunki question pucha ja raha hai. Which injection she would give to the patient. Note down, we have taken she first, then will ko would mein change karke piche le gaye hain. Main verb give is same kyunki will ko would kiya hai. Model verbs hain ya future tense dekhiye, to hum main verb ko change nahi karenge when we change the model verbs. Clear? Look at the second sentence. The patient said to the nurse, who is my doctor? The patient asked the nurse who his doctor was. My pronoun of first person changes with the patient, or third person pronoun ho gaya his. Who his doctor was. Helping verb piche chala gaya hai, subject doctor pehle aa gaya hai. Theek hai, clear? Now in this way the sentences are now in the positive form, simple form, and no conjunction is used because it is a WH question form. Look at the other side where the helping verb examples are given. First example, the patient said to the nurse, is the doctor in? It is a helping verb question form. Is ke saath start ho raha hai. Yes, no answer hai aapke paas. Indirect form, the patient asked the nurse, if the doctor was in, note down the pattern, conjunction if is used, inverted commas removed. Then the subject, the doctor is used first. Is ko change karke was piche chala gaya hai. So it is a simple sentence now. So we are not using any question mark there. Clear? Now look at the second example. The patient said to the doctor, am I suffering from mucus febris? Now look at the indirect form. The patient asked the doctor if he was suffering from mucus fibrosis. Now look at the change. If is used, said is changed into asked, inverted commas removed, conjunction if is used, I first person changes with the patient, he is used, am changes into was. Clear? No question mark, no inverted commas. Look at the next part, that is imperative sentences, where we give sentences in the form of order, request, advice, and sometimes the sentences starting with let in the reported speech also. Or we use if the sentence is in the order form, positive order is given, then sentence starts with the first form of the verb in the reported speech, V1, that means first form. Look at the example, the nurse said to the ward, inverted commas begin, open all the windows of the room for ventilation. Our sentence in the reported speech, open, first form of verb, open se shuru ho raha. And how we are going to change, what are the rules for the changing of the imperative sentences? We use in the reporting verb, we use the verb ordered, requested, advised, commanded, whatever the meaning is given to us in the reported speech. Then for removing the inverted commas, we use conjunction to, and after to, the same first form of the verb is used. We don't change the tense here, note down in the imperative sentences, and it becomes to plus first form, that is to infinitive form. We have already covered this chapter also in your previous classes. What is to infinitive? When we use to plus first form of the verb, and the sentence is changed into infinitive mood because we don't change the tense here. Look at the example, the nurse ordered the ward to open all the windows of the room for ventilation. No change of tense, to plus first form, open. Next example, Alexander the Great said to his commander, be prepared to attack Persia. Again, be is the main verb, first form of the verb from where our sentence is starting, and it is command. Now look at the answer, Alexander the Great ordered his commander to be prepared. B ka B small ho gaya, ab hum capital nahi dal rahe because it is the same sentence in continuation. Inverted commas removed. Conjunction to is used. Clear? Now look at the next slide. If the sentence in the imperative form is given to you in the negative form, starting with don't or never, within the reported speech, if the reported speech starts with don't plus first form in the indirect form, do is removed. In the reporting verb, what we use, not to plus first form. Usko kaise change karoge? Not to. Negative form hai, do not, do remove kar dena hai. Aur not ke saath aapka sentence shuru hoga, then you will add to plus first form as you use in the simple sentences. If there is never, then reporting verb plus never plus first form of the verb will be used. For example, the doctor said to the ward boy, don't allow anyone to enter the operation theater. And in the indirect form, the doctor ordered the ward boy not to allow anyone to enter the operation theater. Not to allow, that means not to plus first form, and said is changed into ordered. Second sentence, Joseph Stalin said to his daughter Swelcher, never dance with that young man again. Joseph Stalin ordered his daughter, you can use here advised also, Svetlana, never to dance, never to, then first form, with that young man again. Next slide, for the request, sentences starting with please or kindly with first form in the reported speech, what we use in the indirect form, subject plus requested plus object plus to with first.